What's good, CBT fam? Before y'all get into the video, make sure y'all hit that subscribe button and that post notification bell to get notified every time I upload content. Peace. What's good, YouTube? It is your boy, Big Cool, coming to you from Colossal Boxing Talk. Colossal Boxing Talk is associated with Three Kings Boxing under the Movement umbrella, and I am back with another video. Former WBO heavyweight champion Joseph Parker is willing to fight the winner or loser of tomorrow afternoon's Tony Bellew, David Haye rematch that's taking place at heavyweight. As you all know, Tony Bellew defeated David Haye by 11-round TKO due to Haye rupturing his Achilles and, you know, not being able to fight properly and defending himself. And of course, the fatigue and stamina issues kicked in because it was a long, grueling fight. But Joseph Parker, who's coming off of his first career defeat, is looking to get back in the saddle. And honestly, this would be a terrific fight against either one of these guys. Personally, I would prefer to see Joseph Parker versus David Haye because I believe David Haye would be more effective and would have a better chance at beating Joseph Parker than Tony Bellew would. I like Joseph Parker. He showed me a lot in his fight against Anthony Joshua, a couple months ago, that he warrants, consideration to still be a top five heavyweight and to, come back against somebody like these two. You know, this would definitely be a good comeback fight. He didn't take a lot of punishment against Anthony Joshua, and I would favor him against either one of these guys. But the explosiveness and power behind David Haye's punches makes this fight very intriguing. David Haye also has fast hands, also a good counterpuncher, just an overall good fighter. But Parker displays speed, defense, good combination punching against Anthony Joshua. And I think that, for a lot of people, myself included, that was questioning or that was really down on Joseph Parker as a fighter, I think we had to come out of that fight with Joshua surprised and pleasantly surprised, like, whoa, this guy can actually compete. You know what I'm saying? Say what you want about the performance, that he didn't come to fight or didn't come to win. I disagree. It was all about strategic, planning. And the only thing that he did wrong was not let his hands go. But other than that, he was able to frustrate Anthony Joshua. He even hit him a couple times, shook him up. You know, it wasn't a typical Anthony Joshua performance. And you got to give credit to Joseph Parker for being able to do that. But, he wants this fight. I'm glad that he wants the winner of this fight or the loser, whoever it may be, because this is a good fight. These guys are close in height and size, so it's a formidable opponent from that standpoint. And skill-wise, it matches up. In terms of potential matchup with Tony Bellew, you got to give Tony Bellew credit. He's he's not a two-weight class champion. He was a contender at light heavyweight, but he was the WBC cruiserweight champion at one point in time. He's a good fighter. After having some, success, but more failures at 175, he moved up to cruiserweight and had some success. And then he moved up to heavyweight and had success by beating David Haye. So either fight is fine with me. I think Joseph Parker beats both guys. He's younger. He's more fresher, more athletic. He's faster. And I think that he's overall, probably better. Probably better, especially with David Haye being at his age and having all the mouths and injuries he's been accumulated over the years. So I think that, we'll see how it plays out. But I'd be very interested in seeing Joseph Parker versus Tony Bellew or David Haye. Depends on how that fight plays out tomorrow. But if you like this video, go ahead and do what I told you to do in the beginning. Drop a comment, head over to Facebook, find the Colossal Boxing Talk Facebook page, like that page, follow me on Twitter at ColossalCBT. Shout out to everybody in the movement that's moving with us. Be sure to check out ThreeKingsBoxing.com daily for your latest and greatest unfiltered, unbiased boxing news reported the way it should be. Until next time, I'm out. Peace.